Former Vice President Al Gore is the author of the new book, The Future, Six Drivers of Global Change. Vice President Gore, it's good to see you. Welcome back.
Thank you, Matt.
You're going to sit down in a lot of chairs like this over the next couple of days to promote this book. Is this something you relish or dread?
Oh, I've been looking forward to it.
Yeah?
Yeah, I feel passionately about the message contained in this book. I've always been fascinated about looking at the future, trying to see over the horizon. I've done that with climate. I do that with a bunch of other big challenges we're facing.
Do you miss politics? Do you miss the chance to weigh in on some of the other issues that are being debated in Washington right now? You said this recently, I'm a recovering politician and the chances of relapse have been diminishing for long enough to increase my confidence that I will not succumb to that temptation again. You don't miss being in there and driving these debates from Washington?
There's some things I miss about it, yes. And I continue to speak out on issues. But one of the themes of this book, Matt, is that our democracy has been hacked. That's a computer term, of course, that implies control of the way our political system works has been taken over. In this case, by big money, corporations designated as persons, anonymous donors, and big money is having a corrupting influence, and it is degrading the quality of our democracy.
And as a result, a lot of things that need to get accomplished simply aren't getting accomplished. When President Obama, in his second inaugural address, talked about the need to work on climate change, I know you applauded that,
yeah.
But you've been critical of the president over the last 4 years, saying that he did not get things done. Here are your words. Senators in both parties said privately that passage of the climate plan might have been within reach, but that it seemed to them that President Obama was not prepared to make the all-out effort that would have been necessary to build a coalition in support of the plan. So are you saying that when he talked about it, President Obama talked the talk but was unwilling to walk the walk on climate change?
Well, there's a lot of truth to that, but there were a lot of factors to take into account. First of all, though, let me say what he said in his inaugural address last week I thought it was fantastic, and it was the first issue he talked about. He spent more time on that than anything else.
But will it get done?
That's the question, but he has now put his commitment out there. I remember as a little kid in Carthage, Tennessee, the first time I went off the high diving board, the key step was climbing that long ladder up, going out to the edge of the board. Then I had to go off it. I was about 5 years old. I think that making the kind of commitment he did is comparable. He's put his presidency behind this issue now. And in his first term, even though, yes, he fell short, he ended up doing more than any previous president, and the opposition has been very difficult. But look at your first story about the flooding in Australia. Today is the 3-month anniversary of Superstorm Sandy here. 2 years ago in my home city, Nashville, massive flooding. These storms, it's like a nature hike through the book of Revelation on the news every day now, and people are connecting the dots.
I'm going to talk more about climate change. You're joining us in our 8 o'clock half hour. I want to talk about some of the other headlines you've made of late. All right, you sold Current TV, the network that you co-founded, to Al Jazeera for an estimated $500 million. According to the reports I've seen, your take on that, about $100 million pre-tax. Was that always just an investment to you? Maybe I was naive.
Oh, no, I thought
it was something that you had an ideological
interest
in. So why did it become just an investment at the end?
Well, it didn't, but I'm proud of what my partner Joel Hyatt and I did with Current TV. We won every major award in television journalism. I'm really proud of it. As an independent network, the only independent news and information network, we found it difficult to compete in this age of conglomerates, and I'm very pleased that Al Jazeera has established itself as a really respected news-gathering network.
And yet, even as you sold to Al Jazeera, you, in the book, blast other television news programs, saying this: virtually every news and political commentary program on television is sponsored in part by oil, coal, and gas companies, not just during campaign seasons, but all the time, year in and year out, with messages designed to soothe and reassure the audience that everything is fine, the global environment is not threatened. And the critics jumped. Mm. And they said, here's the guy who just sold Current TV to Al Jazeera, which gets an undetermined amount of funding from the country of Qatar, which gets its money from oil reserves. Isn't there a contradiction in that?
I certainly understand that criticism. I disagree with it. Because I think Al Jazeera has obviously long since established itself as a really distinguished and effective news gathering organization. And by the way, its climate coverage has been far more extensive and of high quality
but
than any of the networks.
But if they get funding
here
from a country that has, that bases its wealth on fossil fuels, and fossil fuels are the enemy you target in climate change, yeah, isn't there a bit of hypocrisy in that?
Well, I get the criticism. I just disagree with it, because this network has established itself. It's objective. It's won major awards in countries around the world. And its climate coverage, as I said a moment ago, has been outstanding and extensive.
Let me just end with another headline. You're on the board of Apple.
Yeah.
All right. The company's going through some very difficult times. The stock is falling. It's dropped below the market cap of ExxonMobil. Are you worried as a board member about the future of Apple?
Oh, I think it's a fantastic company. You know, of all Steve Jobs' creations, the iPhone, the Mac, the iPad, etc., his greatest was Apple itself. Tim Cook's doing a fantastic job, the executive team and the employees there.
He can carry this company to the future?
Absolutely, absolutely. And by the way, to put it in perspective, this earnings report was, I think, the second largest earnings report in the history of world business. So, no, it's a great company and doing extremely well.
Much more on Washington, much more on the book and your life these days, Al Gore. We'll see you in about 45 minutes.
Look forward to it.
Thank you, sir.